What's up, you guys? I'm King. Today's video is actually going to be quite different from what I normally do. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. But my second video, I created this character in front of a dystopian city. And since then, a lot of people have actually asked me how I came up with what I did there and why exactly I did what I did. And I'll link that video in the description, but for this case, I mainly just reverse engineered the background to fit the character. And of course, you can only do that once there's a character, and there just so happened to be one in that case. But for this video, I'm just going to be drawing a scenery pretty much for the fun of it. And the way that I normally do sceneries is that I'll try to establish a foreground first. Like what I'm doing here, I'm making the trees look darker in the front so that as a result, the back will appear faded in a way. And that works for me because I'm imagining that this forest is kind of foggy and, you know, you're not gonna be able to really see to the end of it. So I'm just gonna be drawing, you know, trees, coloring them in a way that it makes it look like the trees are in different places, even though they're not. But another thing I did, I wanted there to be everything that you would see in a forest, except for animals, because I wanted this picture to be quite empty. So you know exactly where I want you to look when I finish. So at the end, I'm gonna be drawing a river kind of going into the fog. So I left out everything in the center and I started working on the grass and the moss around the trees. I noticed that when you see those in real life forests, you know, there's a lot of moss on the ground around the trees and they're kind of farther away from any light source. Like if the sun shines a certain direction, the moss will be on the other side of the tree. And the light source in this picture is farther away from the viewer. It's not in the foreground at all. So all the moss will be in the foreground. And you know, the grass will have shadows away from all the light sources and stuff like that. So I did all of that according to how I figured the light would be. Another thing that I did, when I used the rocks in order to connect the foreground and the middle ground, I made sure that I put moss on them and especially near the trees to actually make them look like they're one with the trees, like they haven't been disturbed at all. I feel like it really came together. And another thing that I did was, I don't think you guys will see this until the end of the video, but when I finished my river, I went ahead and I put darker shades of the color that I used for the grass on the outline of the river so that it actually looked like the grass was casting a shadow over the river. And I feel like that would really help with portraying like the reflectiveness of it. But yeah, I suppose there wasn't really much to it. It did take a lot of time though. So I guess I'll let you guys enjoy the rest of this video. And yeah, King out.